Right, herein lies an interesting test. We've got some FPV gear in here. I've got an old Rotor Riot camera in here, an old Unify that was just kicking around. Took that off of one of my older drones. It used to work. I plugged it in, it worked. Let's see how this goes. We're running out of sunlight now, so better get up there relatively quickly. And gonna hand launch it with the goggles off and slip the goggles down once we're up and running. So we're on the right channel. Everything's kind of go. Just got to pop the whoop, GoPro in, and we should be on it. Another problem I've got is my transmitter battery seem to be going quite flat before. Should be enough in there for this test anyway, so. Honest, I really gotta do something about this battery. Lights, camera, action! Anyway, heaps of battery as it turns out. Right, let's just slip you inside. The nose. Right, let's pop you in. Probably need to get one more with this daylight, but that's cool. Nose cone. Clipping the clip face, walk down, up, 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 down, good. Got lots of power, dead battery can go in that pocket. Great. Alright! Let's do this. Thank you. GoPro, come on. I found a nose cone. Oh, there's a GoPro right alongside it too. Oh, that's a spectacular eject. Okay, we've run out of light now, so I think I'm gonna call that quits. I will probably, this time, remove the battery. I killed the battery this afternoon by just leaving it sitting in there, idiot. Still plugged in, powering up all the electronics, it's fine. So I've just really haphazardly chucked a Unify.
Telemetry lost.
Pro HV race edition in there, so it only does 200 milliwatts, 200 milliwatts, but it's actually really cool. It's been cooled by the vent in the top there. I kind of feel like once I get the 1 milliwatt jobby in there, it'll probably be okay. Yeah, not too much of a drama. The other thing I did was kill a couple of batteries yesterday, day before, sorry. So I whacked on just this little voltage checker in here. So the theory is that once it gets down below a certain voltage, 3.7-ish, off, that's dumb. Anyway, it starts screaming like a bitch, so you can't miss it. It would go hollery hollery in the sky. The voltage is too high for it to do that, but anyway. I'm having such a blast, man. This is so cool. It's a little bit more peaceful. I managed to cruise down the end of the road there quite happily. The distance to the end of the road is about 1.2 k's. Or thereabouts, I think, off the top of my head. So to have got down there, no trouble at all with this aging Unify, I'm pretty happy with that. That's a good start. Once you get the decent Unify on there, and once I get an OSD so I can tell what I'm doing, then I'll probably get a little bit more game with how far I go. But yeah, this is, it's a whole different ball game, man, but it's cool. Sorry about the piece of grass there. All right, yeah, thanks for stopping by again and enjoying this nice little peaceful end of day flight with me. It's been a blast. I hope you enjoyed it too. Catch you guys later.